Welcome to Daily Zohar. Amar Rabbi Yehuda, the Zohar says, Kama edim asa kadosh baruch hu le'aid bivnei adam. How many witnesses or pillars of testimony kadosh baruch hu created, God had created, to testify upon men? Let's see what does exactly mean. V'chulam, and all of them, be'etza uve'edut omdim kenegdo. And they all stand as a reminder, as a testimony against men. Kam baboker, for example, gets up in the morning, stretches his feet to walk. Those witnesses come and call upon him, ve'omrim, and they say, Raglei chasida v'shmor, from Samuel, Shmuel Aleph, Perkbet. The legs of his righteous he will keep. Shemor aglecha kasher telech, pales ma'agal raglecha. It says also in Mishlei. Mishlei is what? Proverbs. Mishlei, it says in Mishlei, Shemor aglecha, guard your step wherever you go. That's in Kohelet, I'm sorry, that's in Ecclesiastics. In Mishlei it says, Pales ma'agal raglecha. Lefales is to clear the circle of your legs. I never knew what it means. So well, who works in circles? But then, when I was young, I realized that the first time I started, I did martial arts. In Japanese martial arts, you walk like this in circles. You don't walk like this. You walk like this, legs like this, leg like that. So I was walking on the sand, and I said, "Wow, they create circles all around me." So maybe that's what it means. So what does it mean? Lefales is to clear the way. So when you walk like this, you see if there's any obstacles on your way. You won't stumble. You won't fall. So walk in such a way that you won't stumble. I said, "Oh, that's what it means." Walk in such a way that you should be aware of obstacles in front of you. Poteach einav, opens his eyes. For what? Lishtakel ba'olam, to look at the world. Then the edim, the witnesses, says, Einecha lenochach yabidu. Your eyes should look upon what? In Sefer Iyov, it says, I would dwell upon my skin, my flesh, and I would see God. What does it mean? It means you don't need to look far. If you're a person who is wise, a truthful person, you don't need to look far. You don't need to have scientific proofs. You don't need to have all these things to see, to find God. Look at you. Look so close as your body, and you will see God in it. Amazing. I mean, the more you know about the human body, the more amazed one could become at how complicated this machine is. It's simply unbelievable machine. It's like so... It's so complex, like the universe. There's only one body. And how different things interact with other things. And you're saying, only God can do that. Only God can do that. Well, this is when you look at your flesh. Abita besari. I would look at my flesh. But when I look at the mirror, I only see me. I don't see anybody else. I see, well, this nice looking guy there. Right? You only look at yourself. You don't look at God. Basically, when you are so self-involved and you're so mesmerized by yourself and your needs, the less you'll be able to see God in your world. Don't be so involved with yourself. Look, but then think. And it says, Netzor leshoncha mira, seal your lips from speaking bad. Bad about bad people, talk about bad about situations, altogether. Because when you're going to speak bad, everything that comes out of your mouth is negative, 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 negative. Regardless of what will happen, you will develop this negative attitude. You will never be able to see the good. And when you don't see the good, you start complaining. And when you complain, you usually complain about God. And then sooner or later, you take him, you throw him out. So, letzor leshon chamira. Put the safety, lintzor is like in a gun. When you have the safety, put your gun in safety. You will never, even if there is a bullet in the chamber, if it's in safety, you can operate the trigger, because that will create a chain reaction that you cannot stop. As soon as you pull the trigger and you let go, as soon as you let go, your mouth is spoken, the chain reaction of the bullet is unstoppable. You can't stop it. It hits the primer, which shoots a spark into the powder, creates the gas, pressure, thing goes out. You know, who knows what this bullet can do? That's speaking bad. That's not putting a safety on your lips. That's speaking bad, complaining all the time about everything. And it says, not only that, and then Ha'edim, those witnesses say, Sur mira va'ase tov. You have to stay away from bad, but staying away from bad is not good enough. Sur mira, remove yourself from anything bad. And then you have to be involved in positive doing, in asiyah yuvid, ase tov, do good. So it's not only enough to stay away from bad influence or bad friends and so on and so forth. You have to, from that is only one part of it. You have to also be connected to an action that is a positive action, given for yourself to others. It's like the same thing. It's not enough. It's not enough to believe in God. Bezot Hashem, maybe tomorrow we'll speak a little bit about it. It's not enough to believe in God. It's also accepting upon yourself God. Accepting Him into your life. I believe. I don't know what I'm in my life. So, it's called in Hebrew, Kabbalat Ot Ol Malchut. Accepting upon yourself the yoke or the authority of kingdom, and that is God's kingdom. So yes, you might believe in God, but do you really want Him as a part of your life? And that is the question. Because you'll find many people who will tell you, oh yeah, I do believe in God, but this life is not for me. That's not what we're talking about. That is Kabbalat Ol Malchut. And it says, Im shomei alayhem, if he listens to those heavenly voices all the time, not the voices in your head, Pink Floyd style, but if you listen to these things, tov, it's good. Ve'im lo, and if it's not, what we read last week in the Haftarah, ve'asatan, and it says, ve'asatan omed le'imino. And the devil went down to Georgia. The devil is right there by your side. I told you, he's always there. Saying, Shalom. He embraces you. Shalom. Ve'ma'idim alav, and then they will test upon you your avinot, your wrongdoing. Ve'im rotzeh ha'adam la'asok ba'avodat ha'kadosh baruch hu. If a person says, I want to do avodat Hashem, I want to connect myself to become a servant of Hashem. All those witnesses, so-called, became speakers of him on his behalf. And they give a testimony, a good testimony when he needs it. Why? What does it mean? Or a person does something. So now midat adin, the attribute of judgment, will be arising because of what you did. And somebody's going to speak on your behalf. It's going to mellow it down. So instead of being hit, you fell down and just picked something up. And it says, and that's why it's called Edu Tova. And what does it mean? A person gets up in the morning, right away, you make Kama Brachot. Right? Shasali Kol Tzarki, and so on and so forth. Gave me power. Meniach Tfilin Berosho, Ben Einav. You put a Tfilin on your head, between your eyes. Why? Rotze Liskof Rosho, pick up your head up. What do you see? You see the chandeliers? No. Ruei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Because when you put in the tefillin, you don't put tefillin like this. You take the tefillin, you put it up, right? Put it up. Right away, you look up. Almost like the serpent in which Moshe Rabbeinu, Hashem HaKadosh Baruch Hu, told him. He says, make a serpent out of copper and put it there. And they would look up. They would be cured. Not that the serpent will cure them. The fact that they look up in Shamayim. When a person says like this, Ribbono Shel Olam, that by itself, looking up, a person is sighing. People usually don't go like this. Oh, they go like this. What are you doing like this? That is an acknowledgement. Those little things are acknowledgement. And he goes, and he mistakel bekvod Adono. And he's looking at his master, and I'm sorry, the tefillin is on his head, right? V'nirsham al rosho, Hashem HaKadosh. And the holy name has been written on your head, because you put this on your head. And then, retzuot tluyot ze mizeh. The straps go from each side. U'mitzad ze ve'al libo. Then he looks and contemplates and the honor of his master, of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Poshet Yadavim puts his hand out. Ribbono Shel Olam, as you put your hands out, Ro'eh et Hayad Hashniyah, he sees his left hand mitkasheret, is tied and bound bekesher Hashem HaKadosh, in the bound of the holy name. Are you wearing glasses? These are cool. Mitatef beituf shel mitzvah be'arba knafot. You put the talit on. You're wrapping yourself with the mitzvah. It's not a garment. You're wrapping yourself with the mitzvah. Now, we take those mitzvot, and you see that there's more than just putting it on because I have to. Right? When we do, and we spoke about it, many times before, when I'm putting the tefillin on my hand, I'm putting it against my heart. I'm saying, Kadosh Baruch Hu, you're inside my heart. And I want to be a part of your world so much, because when I put my tefillin, what do? I tie myself to you. And you are connected to me, and I'm connected to you. And you go like this, you are by a physical action, signaling for a spiritual connection. And this is all like this. And I'm wrapping myself with a talit. Arba Mlachim, when I do it like this, since I have the Arba Talit, Arba Tzitziot, four kings, spiritual kings, of course, will come out. And they go up for him. And they call Ede Emet Shel HaMelech. They're called the true witnesses of the king. And they come and they give a testimony on him. And they are hanging like grapes from a vine. Ma'eshkol, what's a cluster of grapes, is one, v'tluyim bo kama anavim mitzad ze, and there are many grapes hanging from each side, and there is zagim v'zamurot, and and the grapes, not the one that you buy in the store, they have those little swirls like this, from the vine itself that hangs on, so there's on it, כרוכים בהם שבעה. There are seven of them. רצים אלו, שבע. And what is this? The שבע כריכות של תכלת. Now, this symbolizes the seven wrappings of the תכלת that we do. שצריכים בכל אחת ואחת. או להרבות, or to make more. Like the number 13, up to 13. 13 כריכות. Mishim Mosif Al Yosif Alem. If you want to do, don't do more. Seven, you start with seven, you end up with 13. We have seven and eight. How much is that? 15. Plus 11? 26. Huh?
26.
Mm-hmm. Plus 13?
39.
For the 39 melachot. 39 kiminyan Hashem. 26. Echad. 13. So when you put your talit on and your tzitzit from every direction, basically from anywhere you go, it's a symbolism that the Zohar is trying to tell us here. Basically, anywhere you turn, your tzitzit should remind you that anywhere you turn, in all four directions of the earth, Hashem is one. God is one. Also where? Bashamayim. That's the, it's a tremendous thing. It's not just a garment that I'm putting on. It's not something that the rabbis have made up so I will be hot in the summer. It's beyond that. It's a symbol for me. The Shulchan Aruch writes that when a person does Kriyat Shema, he should take his two tzitziot from the front and he should hold them like this and should contemplate on that. Contemplate. On what? On the 10 knots, because we have the 10 knots, 5 in each one, right? That was supposed to remind us, instead of the tchelet, supposed to remind us of the Eser Sfirot, the 10 spheres of Shamayim, and that should remind me to make tshuva. So I don't have the tchelet, but I have those. And you should look, and it's a contemplation. And all of a sudden you see that what? The Judaism is a different practice altogether. It's very spiritual. And Velamadnu, and we learned that chelet, that blue that we put, is a hint, a sod of David HaMelech, King David. And King David is Malchut. Blue, how do we call this dark blue?
Navy.
Navy blue, also?
Indigo. Royal.
Royal blue. Who said royal blue? Royal blue. Because king used to wear blue. And blue was sign of kings. And we had blue in our tchelet to remind us that we are sons of kings. Who is the king? The one and only God. So when you want to do an averah, chas v'shalom, and you would look at your tzitzit, and you would say the blue, you remember, that's what the Gemara says, I should remember of the blue of Shamayim, that should remind me of the blue of Shamayim, and in return that would remind me of kisei hakavod, and I would not do the averah, I would do the tshuva. Why? But why? Very simple. Because it's my father. I'm going to do something wrong so bad against my father? My own Abba? I can't do that. And I'm a king. I'm royalty. I'm blue blood. Remember? Blue blood. I'm royalty. I cannot do something like this. That's for other people. I'm high class. Today we don't have it. Today the people that we look as our high class, the higher society, or the people, a bunch of garbage. The people with no morals. I mean, just look at the people that our society cherishes. A bunch of lunatics. People with no morals. Cats in heat will have more dignity than some of these people. So think about it. I should follow them. That's idol worshiping. I don't look at that. Show me somebody Who? I tell you that with all the whatever is involved with it, I have more respect to the Dalai Lama than to some of the people that society made into celebrities. As the person says something, it's very smart, what did it come up with? This one wear this dress, this one wear the other dress, this one divorced this one cheated. What do I have to do with this? This is my role model. That's what my kids will look at, the people who achieve something. It's a disgrace to me. I don't want that. So what do I need to do? I need to go within. I need to look at my tzitzit. I need to remember, what is this all about? I forgot. Who am I? I'm so lost. I forgot who I am. It's like a person who suffers from post-traumatic stress disorder and he wakes up and he doesn't know who he is. He says, I'm wearing clothes, a uniform. Well, who am I? Am I a soldier? What's going on here? I forgot who I am. I don't know what this is all about. I don't know if I'm a Taliban or I'm a Delta Force. I don't know who am I anymore. Come, we'll treat you. Come here. I'll remind you what it's all about. We'll give you the unit pride that you forgot. And every unit, every army unit, has its own emblem, has its own sign. And they put it on the flags and on tags and so on. And some people will tattoo it on their body. We have it also. We have the tefillin. We have the tzitzit with special clothing, tzitzit. This is our team color, blue and white. That's why many people at the time were very much outraged at the Zionist movement. It was a secular movement that took colors of blue and white and made them into the flags. But that's a different story. So, and what does it mean, tchelet? Tchelet, the word Hebrew, tchelet, blue, is mishum tachlit. Tachlit means a purpose. Why do I have a tzitzit, blue on my tzitzit? To remind me of the blue, to remind me of Shamayim. To remind me that the purpose of everything I do should direct it towards Shamayim. The purpose of all my actions should be towards God. How do I stand in front of God? So look at what you have and then measure. And sometimes you will get sidetracked. You have your spiritual GPS. Put your hands into your pants. Of course, to your tzitziyot. Pull them out and remind yourself, all right, I got to come back home. That's what it is. It's on my body. It's on my sign. And it says, and by doing so, a person that directs his actions, that is the person that's called a tzaddik. That's a righteous man. A righteous man, according to this, is a person that directs all his actions with a purpose towards Shamayim. And he goes, and the reason why we do that, we put 13 at the end, is 13 for the 13 midot of rachamim. That we say, Rachum, Vechanun, Erech, Hapayim, Rav Chesed, Ve'emet. And these are the 13 attributes, the 13 qualities of mercy and kindness that a person should have upon himself. So when we say, Hashem, Hashem, El Rachum, Vechanun, Erech, Hapayim, we don't go to Hashem and say, Hashem, you merciful ones, you most humble one, you. No, Sakadosh Baruch Hu, we should learn from you to be Rachum, merciful, Chanun, letting go, Erech Hapayim, patient, and so on and so forth. That's why we omitted, we took a part of what comes after that. Right? Not say Chesed Alafim, the Shomrei Brito, those who keep, and those who are not, We took that because it only talks about what we should have done. That's why I'm doing Tachanun, because I should have been merciful. I should have been kind. I should have been patient, and so on and so forth. And he goes, And the Tchelet also represents Yam Kineret, the Sea of Galilee. Right? And the word Kineret represents the kinor, the harp or the violin in which David HaMelech used to sing HaKadosh Baruch Hu at night. And that's why the color of the Tchelet goes all the way up to Shamayim, from one heaven, from one level of the sky, all the way to Kisei HaKavod. And that's why we put the Tchelet on the Tzitzit. Another reason why we put the Tchelet on the Tzitzit, to remind us of all the mitzvot Hashem. Kmo she'ata omer, mitzvot ha-melech hi. This is the mitzvah of the Melech. Why? Because of the color, it's blue. That should remind me of everything. That Tzitzit should remind me of the purpose of everything I do. And then, you were not going to be asked, why are you violating the commandments of the king? That's why we say, Tzitzit is measured against all the shkula kineged kol mitzvot. Because it reminds you of the purpose and the reason why you do things. That's why a person needs to be very careful with mitzvah tzitzit. That's why a person needs to be careful with Shabbat. It's another mitzvah that reminds us that there is measured against all the mitzvot. And on top of all is Torah. Because Torah does not only make you aware of that, of the purpose of life, but also makes you aware of the ways of Hashem and helps you change it. So Bezot Hashem, we should all be merited to be Zoche, to see Malchut Hashem, to see the kingdom of Hashem in this world. B'mirah b'yamenu, b'lev shalem, amen.